For f of x equals x to the third minus 2x plus 3, find g of x equals 2 f of x minus 1. Describe the transformations. So we're talking about the transformation from f of x to g of x, and g of x is 2 f of x minus 1. G of x equals 2, and then times x to the third minus 2x plus 3, and then minus 1. So all I'm doing is I'm taking this f of x and then inputting it here so we can see the transformations. So we can create the g of x function. And without going any further, we can probably describe the transformations. Because a negative 1 here, we're subtracting 1, that means vertical translation of down 1. Also, this 2 in front of the f of x, that means that you're doing a vertical stretch by 2. Okay, so those are the transformations. Now I'm just going to simplify this function a little bit. G of x equals, and I'm going to distribute this 2x to the third, then 2 times negative 2x is negative 4x, and then 2 times 3 is 6, so plus 6, then we have our minus 1. So it should be g of x equals 2x to the third minus 4x plus 5. Okay, so this piece here, this is our function, and right here, these are our transformations. And now I want to go to the calculator to verify this. So y equals, and we'll clear out the old functions. So our f of x is x to the third minus 2x plus 3. Then the g of x is 2x to the third minus 4x plus 5. Okay, let's graph those. Okay, there's f of x. And there's g of x. Okay, so trying to figure out these transformations, it does look like the g of x or the red is stretched compared to the f of x. Let's look at the table and see if we can get a better idea. So we're saying is a vertical stretch by 2 and then translation of 1 down. And basically what that means is comparing f of x and g of x, these two tables, the g of x should be twice f of x, but then take 1 away from that. So it should be like 2x minus 1, for example. So let's take 0 for an input. 2 times 3 is 6, minus 1 is 5. The next input, we have 2 for f of x for an output. Then we'll have 2 times 2, which is 4, minus 1 is 3. 2 times 7 is 14, minus 1 is 13. 2 times 24 is 48, minus 1 is 47. See how the comparison of the f of x and the g of x, the outputs, shows that transformation, that you're stretching vertically by 2, and you're also subtracting 1. So between the table and the graph, you really should get a good idea of what's going on here. That you have a vertical stretch by 2, and then you're subtracting 1.